Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player.
Yeah. Ira Epstein of Lennon Associates with your agriculture update for this Thursday, the 28th of December, 2017, the time 3:07 p.m. Central Standard Time. I'm wearing glasses. I broke an eye vessel. I don't know if it's the cold weather or what. It's happened to me before. It never hurts, but it's ugly. And I did TV shows yesterday. I was on Fox today, BNN, Bloomberg. I've been on everything, and it gets pretty chaotic. I don't want to gross anybody out, so I'll wear the glasses until it looks better. Now, in the ag market, we're still seeing pressure on the grain markets. It hasn't let up, and the beans are probably the leader in the pressure. They just continue downward. You would think some of that pressure might let up at this time of the year. It isn't. In the meat markets, you have a problem in this extreme cold weather. We're not just talking cold. We're talking killer cold weather. In the Chicago area, and we're the warmer part, if you go north of us, it's very cold. We won't be at 20 for days, not at 20. We, at nighttime, are going down to freezing. These are without wind chills. You go above us a bit, you get to the Dakotas, Minnesota. It is unbelievably cold. And this cold has been moving to the northeast with storms, with lots of snow and problems. Now, you take this whole Midwest part of the country and you start getting problems of people maybe not going out. I can't imagine in New York what it's going to be like at New Year's Eve, because it's going to be literally freezing. New York does not get like Chicago typically. It's always warmer. It's going to be bitterly cold. How'd you like to be out there 10 hours waiting for that ball to come down? You'd probably be frozen in place. All right, in the soybean market, what we have here is a market that's been breaking down in waves. It's recently come from 10.03 and a quarter, rallied back up to 9.94 and a quarter, and now it's down today on the end of the day to 9.45 and three quarters. This will be for the Jan beans because it's a weekly area chart of closes. Obviously, you shouldn't be trading Jan. You should be moving to the March by now. And in this market, 10.20 and a half to 9.59, and then we broke through that today, finishing off 9.56 and three quarters. Again, waves to the downside is what I'm trying to show you. You see it on the chart pretty clear, and when I put the swing line study on, and this is a chart without the swing line, for those of you that buy my charting course, that have bought it, either way, you look at this, and I don't care what you say, the moment you put a swing line on a chart, you get to see that a number that should not be violated if you're going to keep the downtrend intact is 976. That does not mean an uptrend has to develop. It means what you need for that. What else does it tell you? It tells you that if you went short at 956 and three quarters on the close, the risk over that 976 is 976 and a quarter. You have an approximate 20-cent risk, so it helps you to identify things. The next thing I put on charts, I filter my swing lines with moving averages. Now, I don't show you all the averages here in these videos. A couple of things I don't do. These videos are on YouTube and other websites. The videos where I say buy, sell, and I put more of my studies is in the morning when my subscriber videos come out, which my students and my charting courses also get to see. You can see how this is working. You had a bearish crossover. Bearish crossover means, see this red 18-day average 2 days ago? It's above the green. Yesterday, both numbers are the same. Today, you get the bearish crossover. That is often, not always, often accompanied by pressure, further pressure on the market, lower break lows. And you did that today. You broke through the break low on that as that happened too. Where might the market go? Well, one of the potential targets is the lower Bollinger Band at 943 and a half. What happened here is, if you think about it, you had sideways action. Look at the Bollinger Bands, these black dashed lines. The ideal situation is when they're super tight, and you'll see, I think corn had one of those, and I'll show it to you. But this was a broader one. It still ended up breaking out, pushing the band down. And notice, you'll close under the band, then you move to the right-hand side of it. The theory of Bollinger Bands is you'll stay within them 95% of the time, but they also beautifully help you to identify pressure building and sideways action and prepare you for the potential of breakouts. When you take a look at what happened here with momentum in the slow stochastic, markets go typically between overbought and oversold. But from there, they can either correct or lock in a further trend. I call that embedding. It's when the slow stochastic numbers, two lines that make up the study called a K and a D line, go sideways under 20 and start staying there. That's often accompanied, when it's under 20, by selling pressure, additional selling pressure, and the flip-flop of it when it's over 80. When we take a look at MEAL, you have the embedded reading. The battleground recently has been the 18-day average. This market didn't have the same pattern as the soybean. In fact, if anything, it had more nothing pattern. Then it got up and it's just completely gone into a state of collapse at this point. You remember, you were up here in the 350s. You're now down to 315. In dollars per futures contract, that's like $4,500. So it's a big break. And maybe it's going to go to the lower Bollinger Band. The market that's been an easier identifying market for resistance and support has been soybean oil. Literally since back here in November, each time it's hit the 18-day average, which I call the line in the sand, when you're under it, it's a resistance point, the market has ended up going either to it, slightly through it, and then failing. It happened again between yesterday and today. In the corn market, this was that sideways action. Notice the difference how it looks than the soybean, and then it started pushing itself to the downside. It's called the breakout. And all that the rallies have done have carried back into there. The market still is under the influence of it and hasn't been able to lift itself up. Yes, the short-term trend has higher lows and higher highs, but it's overbought instantly and not even trying to embed. In the wheat market, overbought, battleground, that neutral number, the 18-day average of closes. You probably got too cheap down here, but the market is also saying there doesn't seem to be a bargain in people rushing out to buy 430 wheat. So another thought you got to deal with. Sugar market made a base action here and just rallied, fought a battle for a while. And I think you'd agree if I can get it to show you this. Yeah, you got up to the 18-day average and the 100. I'd call those the resistance points. The market tried to extend, fell back, challenged it. Again, sideways action staying over. And if it can continue, you'd look for an extension to the upside, which is what the market's trying to do. Now, unless it takes out 1455, even though it's overbought, it may grab those shorts and pull you back into an area here where we get additional resistance that shows up. Coffee market. Coffee had that sideways action, broke out, and this is what you learn in the charting course, to the downside. The easy money was made right here down into this area, and it's been more difficult ever since then as the market has gotten first overbought, playing at the 18-day average of closes. Cocoa market. Sideways action, ending up with momentum turning up at the 18-day average. So you were down here, oversold, couldn't keep your embedded reading. Here was an embedded reading. When you lose the red line under 20, especially more than one day in a row, often price and the 18-day average will come together. And I know you'll say, ah, it's not going to work this time. I believe it works. And there you go. You're back to it. Sometimes it takes a little longer, but it's a warning sign that as much as you might want to get bearish again, be careful. The market owes a number. Cotton's been one of these markets that has proven me wrong. If you look, you lost the bearish embedded read, the bullish embedded reading twice, never made a run here. Happens. What's part of the rules that I give you? When you're over the 18-day average and you lose your bullishness on a stochastic, it's one thing to get out of longs, it's a different thing to get short the market. Same thing when you were down in the cocoa market. It's one thing to cover shorts, very different to get long. Got the idea? Well, I put it all together for you in our charting software, and I'll talk about it in a minute. Cattle market up to the resistance, the upper Bollinger Band, freezing weather. The question is, what's demand going to be like as the weather clears up and animals are able to move back into the consumption lines, let's call them. Same for the feeders, back up to the 18-day average. We had bearish cattle on feed reports just last week. The market's paying no attention, same in the pork. The charts are what I think you look at to get ideas. And in my charting course, I try to teach you these ideas. Now, I want to make this clear. I don't walk on water. But I do, and I have had 40 years of teaching. I've done this a long time, and I believe that if you'll give me the time, I can teach you how to use five different chart studies. Each one builds on each other and filters each other out to give you a game plan. From there, you take it. You start working with the plan. The course itself costs now $129.95. I admit, I raised the price 2 days ago from $109.95 in preparation that come January 2nd, it's $129.95. Doesn't matter. I'm offering you the same discount. The course with the keywords in it, XMAS in the coupon area, $79.95. You're going to learn these studies way more intense than you see me talk about here. I mean, you're talking an apple and an orange. You're also going to learn how to put together the game plans. You're going to learn window envelopes, which I never talk about in the videos that you're seeing on YouTube. You're going to learn how to put this all together, how to recognize these type of patterns as they come. Maybe you're an option trader. You want to learn to take advantage of that. Well, that's going to be up to you with your game plan as you put it on. The charting software that does this alone runs about $100 a month. It's part of the course. My research, everything I'm going to give you, the morning videos where you get about a 10-minute video and I cover 40 charts at a time, trade ideas, I reinforce everything you're learning, included $60 value per 30 days. You got $160 worth of value, and then I'm lowering the price of the course to $79.95 with the 6 hours of video. You can call us, you can go to our website. You'll see under the word education, our course, read all about it before you buy it. But come the first, I'm taking this all off and my price will be $129.95 and then I'm going to raise it even further. You can also see here if you want to get to it, just click on here if you're watching me on YouTube, it'll take you right to the page you need. I'm Ira Epstein. You have yourself a great day. I will be here on Friday making my recordings. I'll see you all then.